Hello everybody! No, it is not me, the one who is whistling right now. It is an enemy of... something. Yeah, this guy that is talking, he says something. I don't know what he says. Maybe he is praying to Santa Claus, this guy here, to bring him something. Some toys for the Christmas. Some good things, goodies, maybe hamburgers, fried potatoes, things like that. I don't know. I don't know what he's talking about. I'm here to tell you, to reveal to you... Finally, Santa Claus build is here. This is the new build in Titan Quest, and we have finally a Santa Claus build. Tan taratarata, jiggle bells, jiggle bells, jiggle all the way. Sentry worker is here today to kill them all today. Yeah. So yeah, this is the build. Build guide of Santa Claus. So, what is this build all about? You know, in this game you can get all of these items, which is the Santa's items. You get these items only when you farm the chest of Toxeus in the secret passage. Both secret passages, as far as I know, also the secret passage of Ragnarok drops these items. But at least you can get these items from the secret passage of Rhodes, Act 4, Hades Act. So, I have the full set. The idea of this build is to have the full set equipped. And go and make a build and go through epic difficulty only. Why? Because the set is not that good to take you through legendary difficulty, so I decided let's make this build and let's play up to epic difficulty and then leave it there. So I decided to make an accomplished hero character. I started at level 40 instantly, which is the official feature of Ragnarok DLC. It gives you the accomplished hero. You start at level 14 Corinth, which in the act of Ragnarok in normal difficulty, you have to go through normal difficulty, but only the north, because you don't gain access to the rest of the acts. You start from here, and if you want, then you can go play Atlantis, which I will do with this character. And after I finish both the north in normal and Atlantis, then I will go to epic. And I will complete all acts in epic difficulty and I will stop there. So now Santa Claus is bright and shiny.
I heard something.
Yeah. Geometry of old games. So, why? I decided to go with a Sentry Worker, this class, which is Dream Master and Rune Master. Why? Because we will be playing with this weapon, which is Santa's Cane weapon. This one is physical damage as the main base damage of the weapon, but it also applies elemental flat damage, the weapon itself. So I thought, okay, let's go ahead and make a Sentry Worker, because with this class you get also this one, rune weapon, which when you hit enemies it increases both elemental damages, total damage and detentions, which means now that it buffs this 29 elemental damage very much, and it also buffs the physical damage output because of this total damage. So yeah, and I decided to go with this class, and this build now has enough offensive ability for normal and epic, perfect defensive ability for normal and epic, so everything is fine. And when it comes to attribute points, I haven't spent any points health and energy. I spent points on your strength, intelligence mostly, and some on dexterity, nothing actually, so far. And I don't need, if I will spend any points on dexterity, because dexterity would help only increasing defensive and offensive ability, which I don't need. Not for normal difficulty, not for epic. Of course, the more offensive you have for a melee bit, the better. But it is not really necessary even for epic. 638 for epic is good enough. We will see. I will be spending points on intelligence and strength on this build. Now you can see, you can hear the ambulance coming from outside. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Okay, so Dream Mastery. As an accomplished hero, I have spent my points here, maxed out this one. Maxed out, maxed out, maxed out. I don't have any other points here, only one point here for now. And here I have 32 skills in the mastery. I have maxed out this one because it is a main skill. I have some points here. My plan is to max out this one because this one, the more you put it, the more points you put here, the more elemental damage you get. So this elemental damage is added to the attacks of this one. and it gets buffed by this one. So yeah, you see that this one will be dealing lots of elemental damage. And I have only 1 point spent so far here. I'm not going to be using this one. I don't care about it.
I heard something.
Not at all.
I heard something.
He heard something three times. We have this one maxed out because it provides offensive ability and strength requirement for weapons and shields. Here we have 1 point only, I think also shield requirements, as far as I remember. But this one is a shield that requires only player level, no strength at all. So yeah. Yeah, 1 point here. I have only 4 points spent here for now. I will put more points here, of course, in the future. And here, more points in the future. And I haven't spent any points here. For the first time ever, I haven't spent any points on Rune of Life. Bleeding resistance is almost perfect for normal. Vitality is okay for normal. In the future, when I start playing Epic, after I level up a little bit, I will spend points here to get some bleeding and vitality resistances. So, this is the build when it comes to skills and points. We have down here the skills, Trance of Wrath. We have here the rune weapon, and we have here the thunder strike. These are the skills. Now, for the items, what do we have? We have the items of the set. Sada's Cane. We talked about this item already. Sada's Wither Coat. This is a nice item. This guy is hearing too many things. It provides a little bit of recharge reduction, which is very nice, a defensive ability. We have the Sada's Hat, it provides offensive ability and health, very nice item. We have the Sada's Gloves, it provides offensive ability, very nice item. We have Sada's Boots, it provides defensive ability. And we have this one, the Shield, which provides health. Yeah, and energy and health regen. One thing, very very nice thing about these items is this one. This one provides a huge amount of cold resistance and reduced freeze duration, 100%. This one provides a huge amount of poison resistance and stun resistance, 100% at least. This provides a huge amount of lightning resistance, 116. This provides a huge amount of pierce resistance and also a good amount of reduced entrapment. So, these items are very nicely made. You know, in the old Immortal Throne version of the game, these items are, they don't have these stats, they are totally useless. But in Anniversary, the developers decided to make these items useful. This is very good because this set looks awesome and it is a very nice, Easter egg set to play with. So now you can use the set to play in Epic difficulty at least. You can go in Legendary with this set, especially if you upgrade all of the items of the set. But I decided not to do that. I don't know, maybe I will do it. We will see. My goal is to play up to Epic at least. Now, for the other items we have, Heart of Earth. This is a great item because it provides buffs to survivability and also damage output. Very nice buffs. Flat damage to physical. 30 to 60, up to 60 damage. This has been used when we attack with our weapon, and also when we use skills like this one that utilize weapons. So, oh! Dude! Yeah! Oh! Oh! This was the skill Flame Strike. Yes! When we were talking about this artifact, this enemy came here just to showcase to you how this Flame Strike skill works. I mean, these things happen only with Santa Claus build. Very nice artifact for this build and for whatever we are going to be doing with this build. Here we have the Mark of the Overlord. I decided to go with this one for now to get defensive ability, health, even also survivability, and also the 50 armor, which is very nice. Here we have the Signet of Hope. This is very good because it provides resistances, survivability, and less damage from undead demons, which fits the build, the theme of the build very perfectly, I would say. And also, I'm using this one because of Signet of Hope, because of the name of the item as well. Because hope, it's Santa Claus, you know. Little kids hope that Santa Claus will bring them good toys and stuff as gifts during Christmas. So yeah, I think it fits perfectly to the theme of the build. And here we have Amulet of Hygieia, because it provides great survivability resistances, and again because the name of the item itself, Amulet of Hygieia, is it fits perfectly the theme of the build, because everybody hope they will have good health, and they hope, sign it of hope, that Santa Claus would bring them good health as well, because Hygieia is the Greek word for health. In Greek, the right pronunciation is Igia. Igia means health. This is the build. My plan is later, after I level up, to equip this one, Seal of Hephaestus. This one will help the build very nicely. I don't know, maybe I will take off this one or this one. Even though if I take off this one, I will kind of destroy the theme of the build. Actually, the build is based on the set, not this one, so we will see. And maybe I will use this one as well later, in epic difficulty. So, I will go kill a couple of enemies, so that you can see how this build plays. Yeah, everything is easy normal now, of course, this makes sense. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. I'm killing bandits in the game and calling for today. Nobody can mess with Santa Claus. Άλλα λέει, ο Santa Claus κάθεται και κλαίει. Oh. Yeah. Summon whoever you like, I will kill you all. We are going to kill the boss, Skyren. Of course, now you will think, Santa Claus killing. Well, yeah. Sometimes when you want to bring good things to the world, you have to get rid of the bad things of the world. In this case, the bad thing of this world is Skyren. It is one of the bad things. So, how do you get rid of Skyren, the bad thing? Well, you have to kill him. It is not a bad thing, you know. Just kill Skyren. Killing Skyren is a good thing always. Sorry Skyren, but Santa Claus is Santa Claus. Yeah, you know Skyren, my boy. Actually Skyren, you should feel honored by because you got killed by Santa Claus. This is a very big honor. Something very very rare to happen. This happens once every 10 trillion years, so yeah. I'm not expecting to get any good drops here, I'm just killing these enemies for you to see the gameplay. But actually guys, this is the gameplay. The gameplay is super duper simple. Because this build uses only a couple of skills. Actually, it uses one oral type skill, one basic attack skill, and one casting skill. One of the three. We have no pets whatsoever, no scrolls here. So yeah. Let's go take care of this Arpis. Chakachuka. These enemies are very annoying, but anyway. The good thing is that Trance of Wrath gives you skill disruption. And when this skill disruption triggers on these enemies, then this is a very good thing for you. Nice. Now Santa Claus is getting rid of Senders. Yeah. Of course, in epic difficulty, things will become much more interesting for this build because I will start leveling up more. I will be using more skills, probably. Maybe I will equip some better items. Many things you can do. So, this is the build, actually. Very simple, very easy. In normal. Yeah, because when I get to epic difficulty, I will lose resistances because we get resistance penalties here. Minus 40% resistances in epic difficulty, which means my 23 vitality resistance will go down to minus 20. Minus 23. So yeah, minus 23 vitality resistance is not the best thing in Titan Quest to have. Ta-ra-da-da-da. Let's explore. Nice. Now we are killing male Gorgons. How can this happen? I don't know, don't ask me. Da-da-da-da. Very, very nice. Very smooth, very easy. Oh yeah, unfortunately this skill doesn't trigger all the time, you know. Unfortunately recharge reduction doesn't work on skills from items and artifacts, which is a very bad thing. Imagine if we could reduce the 90 seconds of recharge of this skill down to 50, for example, or to 20, whatever. That would be awesome. But anyway, this is the gameplay, guys, of this build. Let me know in the comments below if you would like me to live stream this build. If yes, I will do it, of course. Especially in the 25th day of December, which is, I think, Friday, which means I will be live streaming at that day. So, if you will be here, then maybe we will live stream this build in that specific day. Maybe. Who knows? If you want me to do that, let me know down in the comments section. So, Santa Claus build is here. Guys, this is it. Thanks for watching this video. Hit the like button if you like Santa Claus build. Hit the dislike button if you hate Santa Claus. Subscribe. We have much more content coming up. And I will see you very soon with more live streams, videos, and whatnot. Who knows? And if you got to check out my other YouTube channel, The Radio Boards, which is a musical channel. It's very different from this one. But maybe you will find there something that you would like. Or if you got to support me, you know, you can just subscribe there and help grow that channel as well. So, I will see you very soon again. Have a good day.